Prostate artery embolization, PAE, has taken more prominence in this year's Congress, and I think that's hardly surprising. The evidence is now coming in thick and fast. We've got our first two randomized controlled trials from Sao Paulo in Brazil and from China. We've got registries starting in the UK, in Italy, and in France. And I'm heavily involved in the British registry, which is the UK ROPE. You know, this is a really exciting area, and if it gets full recognition by NICE, that's the National Institute of Clinical Excellence in the UK, and other regulatory authorities around the world, there will be a demand for embolization. I have little doubt on it.
Indications for prostatic artery embolizations are for patients suffering from lower urinary tract symptoms, like nocturia, weak urinary stream, and hesitance. So these are the main indications for patients that suffer from there and that interferes in quality of life. The PErFect technique is the second generation of the prostatic artery embolization technique. With this technique, we have observed more necrosis of the prostate, and as a consequence, a reduction in the prostate size and symptoms improvement. We have seen much better results using it, so we advise physicians, if they want to start with prostate embolization, that they should try to use the PErFect technique.
At CIRSE 2016 in Barcelona, I was able to be involved in some industry-sponsored workshops on prostatic artery embolization for benign prostatic hyperplasia. And we talk about different aspects of the procedure, from the selection of the patients, inclusion criteria, technical aspects, including anatomy variations and how to manage difficult cases, and also the result, follow-up and the results of patients after a PAE.
Embolization of the prostate is one of the hardest things we do. So the people who should be looking to start up a service should already have a lot of embolization experience, whether that's in fibroid embolization, liver embolization, embolization in AVM, but essentially the common ground here is a lot of experience in microcatheter work.
The advice that I would give is to start this procedure in combination as a team with urologists. This is very important. The other thing is to understand the disease, to speak the urological language. That's why you should work in collaboration. Be well trained, understand anatomy, understand the disease, and work in collaboration.